I don't know. Welcome back, everyone. It's been a while. We have now been getting rain for the last, 2 weeks. It has amounted to now almost a foot of rain in the last, actually since at the beginning of last week to now. We've just been getting a lot of rain. You guys seen earlier in the year I had video of cutting down that marsh grass. We cut down some more. But the thing is we'll zoom in. You can see what's standing and what's not, or what's shorter and what's taller. Well, from that tall stuff to that other tall stuff there, there's still windrows down there. Me and my grandpa had chopped some, two Fridays ago, I think. We went ahead and gave it a whirl after we got about 3 inches of rain 2 days prior. And we got almost a full load. And as we were going to hopefully get more of it chopped the next day, but as my grandpa was coming back with the last pass, to finish filling up the wagon, because let's just go down and come back and unhook and unload it. He got about halfway from being done with the round coming back and buried the MX pretty good. Good thing is we just unhooked the wagon and pulled the track, or got the MX and chopper out. And then we just came in from the north, I'll walk over here and show you. From the north area, because we were heading west, and then we just came in from the north and pulled it out. So where I'm talking is the tip of my finger at the right, there's the bin there. There's tall stuff right in that section there is where the wagon got stuck. We were heading west. So we just unhooked, he just drove out, and then circled around, and then we just pulled the wagon out this way. And then, we got it out, unloaded it, and because we got all this rain, it's now, I don't know, I haven't looked at the rain gauge after this, but should be around almost 12, 13 inches of rain so far in the last week and a half. So we're not going to get down there anymore this year, because it's peat ground, it's real soft. Even an inch of rain, it's soft. You can't get in it because there's so much organic matter in that ground that it just soaks it up and you just sink. And because we had 3 inches and we went and chopped it because we needed some kind of bedding, we were hoping to get it raked over a month ago, but now because there's so much, it's gonna take until like November to get it dried out, but by then it's not gonna be worth it. But there will be, I'm hoping to get, we're gonna be cutting a little 3 acre hay field, getting that cut, baled up, then the mower can come off for the year. The chopper's already off. Someone asked, why don't we chop it? Well, we don't have a use for haylage. It'd be better as dry hay. But last Tuesday, about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, we had lost power, and we had a bunch of rain too, lost power, and then we got it back Wednesday, 24 hours later, almost right on the dot, 24 exact hours, we were out of power. Good thing is we got a generator, so we were able to feed the calves at night the next morning and at least keep our refrigerators and freezers cold for a while. And I was going to get footage, or at least snap a picture of the 1030 running. It'd be the cabbed one right there. Yep, he ran the generator pretty good. Lights were flickering a little bit. They were flashing, because the tractor wasn't spinning fast enough. The tractor was spinning at, let's say, 2100 RPM instead of 1850, lights would have stayed on better, but we got through. Kind of so you don't realize how dependent on electricity you are until you're out. And it's like, well, we can't because we need power for this, and had a big branch fall off a tree, and yeah, we've just been getting nonstop rain. I heard of some guy, a couple guys are starting to chop corn silage around this area, which is the beginning of September, and there's corn silage coming off already. That shouldn't be until like the middle of September, but it is what it is, and it's going to be a wet one because of so much rain, but whatever. It's Sunday afternoon. I got chores to do. I figured I'd make this video, get it uploaded tonight, so then I can enjoy my Labor Day. So, until then, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to check me out on Instagram and Snapchat, both Working on Farms, and stay dry, my friends.